Hi there, from the Texas Instruments Voltage Supervisors product line. We present our series of short videos called Voltage Supervisors 101. For the fourth video of our Voltage Supervisors 101 series, we are going to cover in detail the output and timing specifications of a voltage supervisor. Specifications for a voltage supervisor can be divided up into three main categories: input, output, and timing features. For this video, we will go into details on the output, which include topology and polarity. We will also go into detail on timing, which include propagation and reset delay. Voltage supervisors come in two different types of output topologies: open drain and push-pull. Open drain supervisors contain one internal N MOSFET and requires an external pull-up resistor to create a logic signal output. Push-pull supervisors utilize a pair of complementary MOSFETs internally, one P MOSFET and one N MOSFET. There are pros and cons to each of the output topologies mentioned, and depending on your system requirements, one topology may be more suitable than the other. For an open drain supervisor, the reset output will either pull up to V pull-up if the N MOSFET is open, or will pull down to ground if the N MOSFET is closed. One advantage of the open drain output is that it can pull up to any voltage that complies with the logic of the load, rather than pulling it up to only VDD of the supervisor itself. For example, if the VDD is 3.3 volts, but the load can only accept up to 0.8 volts, then by using an open drain supervisor, the V pull-up voltage can be set to 0.8 volts to comply with the load. Another advantage of the open drain output is that multiple open drain outputs can be wired or together. This is useful if a device has multiple voltage rails that need to be monitored but only has one enable pin. If any of these supervisors pull to ground to signal an under voltage condition on its monitored voltage rail, the output will be pulled to ground regardless of the other monitored voltage rails. One disadvantage of the open drain supervisor is its need for an external pull-up resistor, which adds to costs as well as consumes space on the board. Another disadvantage is the higher current consumption when a fault condition is present. During such a state, the N MOSFET is closed, which pulls current through the pull-up resistor into ground, resulting in the reset output going low. Due to this effect, power will be lost or dissipated. For a push-pull supervisor, if the output of the reset logic timer is high due to an undervoltage condition, the P MOSFET opens and the N MOSFET closes, causing the reset output to pull down to ground. On the other hand, if the output of the reset logic timer is low, indicating a normal operating condition, the P MOSFET closes and the N MOSFET opens, causing the reset output to pull up to VDD. The advantage of a push-pull supervisor is its ability to conserve power during an undervoltage condition. During this condition, the push-pull topology will close its N MOSFET while opening its P MOSFET, pulling the reset output low. As a result, no power is lost as no current is being drained to ground, whereas in an open drain topology, the pull-up resistor forces current to drain to ground, causing power loss. In addition, since no pull-up resistor is required for a push-pull supervisor, cost is reduced and quality is improved due to the reduction of discrete components. One disadvantage of the push-pull output is that multiple outputs should not be wired or together. When one supervisor detects an undervoltage condition and the other supervisors detect a normal voltage operating condition, the supervisor detecting the undervoltage condition will pull to ground, while the other supervisors will pull up to VDD. This effect causes a metastable state at the enable pin of the monitor device and would likely lead to system failure. Another disadvantage of the push-pull supervisor is its ability to only pull up to VDD. Depending on the load connected to the output of the supervisor, the VDD of the supervisor may be either too high or too low for the logic level of the load. In such a case, it may be more beneficial to use an open drain supervisor where the user can control the pull-up voltage at the output. So far in this video, we have only shown active low output polarity supervisors. In active low supervisors, when an undervoltage condition is detected, the supervisor will pull its high output low. Depending on your system requirements, however, an active high output polarity supervisor may be needed. During normal operating conditions, the reset output voltage level will be low. If an undervoltage condition is detected, the reset output voltage level will be high. This could be useful for a device with an active high disable pin or disabling a P-type MOSFET that requires a high logic level at its gate to turn off. One final output specification to consider when designing with supervisors is output timing. For active low devices, high to low propagation delay, or TPDHL, is the time that a supervisor takes to assert its reset output after an undervoltage condition occurs at vSense. Low to high propagation delay, or TPDLH, is the time that a supervisor takes to deassert its reset output after vSense rises above the positive going threshold voltage. In this example, when VMON crosses VMON UV of 2.93 volts, TPDHL will be 9.9 microseconds. Or in other words, it will take the supervisor 9.9 microseconds for its reset output to change from a high logic level to a low logic level. When VMON crosses VMON UV plus hysteresis, TPDLH will be 28.1 microseconds. Likewise, it means the supervisor will take 28.1 microseconds for its reset output to change from a low logic level to a high logic level. For active low supervisors, in addition to the low to high propagation delay, some also have a critical output specification called reset time delay. This specification is only relative to the deassertion of the reset output when VMON crosses its positive going threshold voltage and is induced by the reset logic timer within the supervisor. In general, reset time delay is orders of magnitude larger than the propagation delay. An example of why reset time delay is important is if the supervisor were monitoring an MCU. By holding the reset low after VMON crosses its positive going threshold voltage, the reset time delay guarantees that the MCU has enough time to clear its memory bank before starting up. Another example of why reset time delay is important is if there are multiple voltage rails in the system that need to be powered up in a sequence. A supervisor with a reset time delay can be used to ensure one voltage rail powers up after all the other voltage rails are powered up. In a basic supervisor, this reset time delay is a fixed amount. In the example shown, the reset time delay is 200 milliseconds. We call these supervisors with a fixed reset time delay. In a supervisor with additional features, this reset time delay could be adjusted by utilizing an external capacitor. We call these supervisors with an adjustable reset time delay. This concludes our video on the output and timing features of a voltage supervisor. Texas Instruments has one of the widest breadth of products in its voltage supervisors portfolio. To learn more, please visit us at www.ti.com/supervisors, where you can find supervisors with different features, read our tech notes and blogs, and use the TI ETE support page to ask any questions.